Yaskawa.
You're watching the IEC 61131 Basics video tutorial series. In this edition, we'll use the Logic Analyzer, an important graphical monitoring tool in MotionWorks IEC. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier, and I'd like to show you how to use the Logic Analyzer along with our parking gate control example project and the PLC simulator. So follow along with me as I show you how to do the trigger setup, capture some data from the project, and use zoom and cursors for simple measurement. The Logic Analyzer is a graphical monitoring tool. You can have up to 16 variables, and you'll be able to see them here all with data sampled at the same rate. You do have to have MotionWorks IEC open at the time, and you do have to have debug mode on. You just go to View Logic Analyzer, and I'll show you also how to undock the window so that it's large enough to get a good view of the data. So I do have the PLC running. Let's just do another make and download and warm start here to be sure that it all works. Okay, now I'll go do a stop and download. We have the system tick warning, yes. And warm start. Okay, now close this resource. And let's go to debug mode and look at the Logic Analyzer. So my Logic Analyzer comes up down here. And I had mentioned that it's very small. Can you imagine having 16 channels of data displayed in this little box? So the way to get at it is you right-click where it says Logic Analyzer and uncheck Allow Docking. This may make it any shape. So you can use standard techniques to make this Logic Analyzer larger. And then some people like to move it out of the way or even close it, because we need to do the next step. The next step is to add variables by right-clicking anywhere in the code or within a global variable or local variable list. You just right-click and choose Add to Logic Analyzer. So why don't we add these four, G number of cars, DI0, G gate open, and DO0. I'll add a G number of cars and G gate open from the code, and I'll add the inputs and outputs from the global list. So in the project tree, we had that code in the main POU, and here's G number of cars, add to Logic Analyzer, G gate open, add to Logic Analyzer. I can pull this up here and you'll see that those two have been added. It's also possible to add even if it's closed. The others I'll add from the global list. You could also add them from the code. Here's DI0. Add to Logic Analyzer, and DO0, add to Logic Analyzer. I can view the Logic Analyzer once again, and there are my four channels. But having the variables is not enough. We need to set up what's called the trigger configuration, and you right-click on this tab, choose Trigger Configuration, and that will let you set up the number of cycles, the variable at which to trigger, and the task at which you will take the data. So do that along here with me. You'll right click on the configuration resource, trigger configuration. And what I like to do, in fact, is look at the task that I'm in first, because that affects the number of cycles that I would want to use. So I chose the fast task. Why the fast task? Well, because my data, he's even indicated here, is in the fast task. I took my two variables from the fast task. Makes sense to synchronize with the place that the variables are being used. Now, what about number of cycles? My number of cycles I have here is 100, but do you remember, what is the interval for the fast task? If you remember that message we saw at the beginning, it said my fast task was at 20 milliseconds. So if it's 20 milliseconds and I have 100 cycles, that would be 2,000 milliseconds, or 2 seconds. How about I do 200 cycles, and if my interval is 20 milliseconds, I'll have 4 seconds then to do something here and take data for 4 seconds. Then when you start taking data, it won't actually start to count these samples until it sees this trigger condition. You can use any of the variables to create a trigger condition. And one way to do it here, I would like to choose DI0. So when I go turn on DI0, that's how I know it will start to take the graph. And you could create any type of Boolean expression. A real easy one is to use RE, rising edge. And I didn't say anything about pre-recording cycles, but you could get also a little preview of what happens before this event, this trigger event. I'm just going to leave it at 0 for this one. Let's click OK. Now to record the data, be sure you're in debug mode with the trigger configured. And you can right click on configuration resource tab of the logic analyzer and use start recording. You'll also notice a recording button up at the top. You can also use that. So we'll hit start recording and then start the graph by toggling DI0 several times, and that first rising edge will be what starts the logic analyzer graphing. So let's record some data. I'll do a couple checks here first. What I want to do is click on this input several times and watch the number of cars go up to the maximum. I think I'll do a lower number than 20. Let's do 10. Overwrite 10 here. We also need to be open for business. That's input number 1. And this shows the gate open. And now we can hit record by right-clicking here, start recording. Just move this out of the way to be sure everything works. And it's really not recording anything yet until I do rising edge on input 0. 10 clicks in 4 seconds. All right, did I get them all? Yeah, it looks like I didn't. I'll have to do it again. I'll do it a little quicker. I'll reset that. And let's record again. I'll use this button this time. Start recording. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. There, I got them all. So now I can see what happens as the sensor is hit and the gate goes from open to closed. And I guess I had something illogical here, which is that if the gate's closed, there wouldn't be more cars running over the sensor, but you get the idea. Here it is, here's the output, closing the gate. So now we need to do some analysis, and the first thing here is to zoom. And zooming happens by doing right-click and drag and left-click and drag over the axes. Let's go give it a shot. Let's say I want to drag in and look at this event here. So I'm doing left-click and drag, and now right-click and drag. And you can see down here the cursor kind of changes the icon. You can indicate that here. This is also possible. Left and right click and drag happens, works the same way on the vertical axes. And so that allows you to adjust for easier measurement. And since I mentioned measurement, there is the possibility of cursors. The cursor, you click on the very edge here, and then as you move your mouse, you'll be able to put a cursor and a little sample measurement box pops up. So we could look at the cursor here. It also, you notice the cursor makes the icon change. And I can move that here and see what, when did that happen? It happened at 170 samples. And I have 10 cars at that time. The cursor does stay with the window as opposed to the data. And that's the cursor. You can also have an amplitude cursor up here at the top. Doesn't tell you the time, but tells you each level according to the data that you have. You can do capture curves to restore the zoom. If you want to do any measurement, at this point, at this version, you just need to put down a cursor, make a mental note here. It is sample 17.8, so zooming in can be helpful. You want to see how many scans, how many cycles this particular input was on. Here it says we're at 17.9, and this one's at 27.1. Version 3 of MotionWorks IEC will have an improved logic analyzer. So if your logic analyzer looks different than this, rest assured that we'll be making a new video soon that shows how to use the newer Logic Analyzer with better and more intuitive features. And so this is it for now. Use the Logic Analyzer anytime you need to have a closer look in time what's happening with different variables. Sometimes this is the only way to tell if your code is working properly or not.